So Ahlul Sunnati believe that there's a scale the Day of Judgment. And that scale, the people will be weighed upon it, the Day of Judgment. Anyone whose scale is heavy, inshallah, with the mercy of Allah added to it, inshallah ta'ala, he will enter Jannah because of that. The people whose weight doesn't make it through are two types. Pay attention. A people whose weight is what? It was very light and you couldn't make it. They will enter the hellfire. Huh? And they are the believers. They will enter the hellfire and Allah will take them to Jannah. Or Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will take them to Jannah and forgive them straight away. The second type of people are the disbelievers. And they will be taken to hellfire. They will never come out of it. They will never come out of it. The Shaykh then goes on to say, وَكَذَا السِّرَاطُ يُمَدُّ فَوْقَ جَهَنَّمٍ فَمُوَحِّدُ النَّاجٍ وَآخَرُ مُهْمَلُ. The Shaykh said, وَكَذَا السِّرَاطُ. We believe in the sirat. Sirat is what? The sirat is a jisrun. It's a bridge. The sirat is a bridge. That falls over what? يُوضَعُ عَلَى مَتْنِ جَهَنَّمَ. It falls on top of the brink of Jahannam. That's where Allah said in the ayah, وَإِن مِّنْكُمْ إِلَّا وَارِدُهَا كَانَ عَلَى رَبِّكَ حَتْمًا مَقْضِيًّا ثُمَّ نُنَجِّ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا وَنَذَرُ الظَّالِمِينَ فِيهَا جِثِيًّا. That Jahannam, there's a jisr, a bridge that goes above it. Who is going to make it? What is it? It's called what? Pay attention to this. It's a very powerful statement I'm going to say, inshallah ta'ala. This is called the sirat, right? If you want to make it, as Ibn al-Qayyim said, the sirat of Jahannam, that goes over Jahannam, the Day of Judgment, if you want to make it through, make it on the sirat of this world. وَأَنَّ هَذَا صِرَاطِي مُسْتَقِيمًا فَاتَّبِعُوهُ وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا السُّبُلَ فَتَفَرَّقَ بِكُمْ عَنْ سَبِيلِي ذَلِكُمْ وَصَاكُمْ بِهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. There's a sirat in this world, which is the Prophet's sirat. Tread on it today. Don't innovate. Don't come with shirkiyat and kufriyat. Follow that sirat. The Prophet sat down, he took a twig, alayhi salatu wasalam. When he recited the ayah, look what he said. وَأَنَّ هَذَا صِرَاطِي مُسْتَقِيمًا. Look what the Prophet did, alayhi salatu wasalam. خَطَّ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ خَطًّا. He took a twig and he made a line on the road, on the earth. وَقَطَّ عَنْ يَمِينِهِ وَعَنْ شِمَالِ خُطُوطًا. And then on the left and on the right, he made a little lines from the sides that go out of it. And then the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, every one of those khutut on the left and the right, there are shayateen who are calling to it. This is my path. And the Prophet recited the ayah, وَأَنَّ هَذَا صِرَاطِي مُسْتَقِيمًا فَاتَّبِعُوهُ. Follow my path. وَلَا تَتَّبِعُ السُّبُلْ. Don't follow those paths. Don't follow these sects. Don't follow these groups. Don't follow these organizations that are made based upon hawa, whims and desires. Hizbu this, Hizbu ta'rir, Muhajirun, what's it called? Muhajirun. Kul firqa dalala. Misguidance. Stay away from it. Allah says, وَلَا تَكُونُوا مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ مِنَ الَّذِينَ فَرَّقُوا دِينَهُمْ وَكَانُوا شِيعًا كُلُّ حِزْبٍ بِمَا لَدَيْهِمْ فَرِحُونَ. وَلَا تَكُونُوا, do not be مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. Don't be from the pagans and the polytheists. Why? Why? Don't follow their actions. مِنَ الَّذِينَ فَرَّقُوا دِينَهُمْ وَكَانُوا شِيعًا. Who broke their religion into groups and sects. كُلُّ حِزْبٍ, every sect. كُلُّ حِزْبٍ بِمَا لَدَيْهِمْ فَرِحُونَ. He's happy with what he has. Everyone says, oh, I'm good, alhamdulillah. That's not. شَرَعَ لَكُمْ مِنَ الدِّينِ مَا وَصَّى بِهِ نُوحًا وَالَّذِي أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ كَمَا وَصَّيْنَا بِإِبْرَاهِيمَ وَمُوسَى وَعِيسَى أَنْ أَقِيمُوا الدِّينَ وَلَا تَتَفَرَّقُوا فِيهِ. Establish this religion and don't divide. Follow the prophetic path. مَنْهَجُ النُّبُوَّةِ. The prophet's path, in which he, that day when he took it, he said this. What is that path? He told us, عليه الصلاة والسلام. Pay attention to this. He said, سَتَفْتَرِقُ أُمَّتِي عَلَى 73 فِرْقَةٍ. My ummah will divide. This is going to happen. It is sunnah of Allah. No one can change it. 73 sects. The ummah going to break into. All of those 73 sects, kulluha fi nari, all of them are in the hellfire. Illa wahida, except one. Now you have to, your ears have to be out and listen, and your heart has to be ready. What is that one that's going to make it? Because you want to be from that saved sect. That one who are called ta'ifatul mansura, firqatul najiyah, the saved sect. Who are they? The Prophet didn't say it's this person and it's that person and it's that person. He gave a description. If you come with it, you can be from them. إِلَىٰ قِيَامِ السَّاعَةِ, as long as you come with this set description. What is it? مَنْ كَانَ عَلَىٰ مِثْلِ مَا أَنَا عَلَيْهِ الْيَوْمَ وَأَصْحَابِي. That which I and my companions are upon. Underline that. What the Prophet knew, what the Prophet did, what the Prophet said, what he consented to alayhi salatu wasalam, and that which his companions were upon, that is what you want to be upon. Whatever they didn't know, whatever they didn't like, whatever they didn't agree with, stay away from it. Stay away from it. In another hadith, the Prophet said, Al-Jama'ah, the group. When he was asked, who are the ones that are going to make it? He said, Al-Jama'ah. This hadith explains the other hadith, and they are shahid for one another. Are you with me? The Jama'ah here, who's who? The Sahabas and the Prophet, because they were the only Jama'ah at that time when the ayah came down. Allah said in the ayah, وَمَنْ يُشَاقِقِ الرَّسُولَ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُ الْهُدَىٰ وَيَتَّبِعْ غَيْرَ سَبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ نُوَلِّهِ مَا تَوَلَّىٰ وَنُسْلِهِ جَهَنَّمَ وَسَاءَتْ مَصِيرًا. That's a path other than the path of the believers. So he goes against the Prophet and he goes against the path of the companions. And then the ayah that I read before, وَالسَّابِقُونَ الْأَوَّلُونَ مِنَ الْمُهَاجِرِينَ وَالْأَنصَارِ وَالَّذِينَ اتَّبَعُوهُمْ بِإِحْسَانٍ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمْ وَرَضُوا عَنْهُ. Every matter, you ask yourself, what did Allah, where's the evidence for this? قَالَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى هَيَّ. Who understood it like that from the salaf of this ummah? The Sahabas, what did they say about this ayah? أَلَا يَسِعُنَا مَا وَسِعَهُمْ. Does it not suffice us what suffice them? Does it not? Of course it does. It should suffice us. So, the person who's going to make it on that path is the people who are upon that path that the Prophet knew he was aware of when he was alive. So follow the salaf of this ummah. Their methodology. Don't introduce a new way of life. Don't introduce this, don't introduce that. Follow them in it. Don't be a person who follows. Naam. وَكَذَا الصِّرَاطُ يُمَدُّ فَوْقَ جَهَنَّمٍ فَمُوَحِّدٌ نَاجٍ وَآخَرُ مُهْمَلُ. The people are two types on the sirat. How many types? Two types. The first type is who? The first type is فَمُوَحِّدٌ. He's a muwahid. He worships Allah alone, does not associate partners with him. Who does he worship? Allah alone. He only worships Allah alone. And he does not associate any partners with him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he follows the messenger in everything that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam legislated. He tries to follow the Prophet in it. He doesn't introduce. فَمُوَحِّدٌ نَاجٍ. That person is successful. وَآخَرٌ مُهْمَلٌ. And the other one is a forsaken one, a one that's destroyed. He's the one who went against the tawheed, and he went against the mutaba'ati rasul, in following the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Going against the messenger. So if you want to make it, pay attention. On the sirat, which is hissi, the tangible sirat, make it on the sirat, which is ma'nawi, this one on this earth. Do you want to know if you're going to make it on that sirat? What are you on the sirat that you're on right now? The one that we ask Allah 5 times a day. In every rak'ah, ihdina sirat al-mustaqim, sirat al-ladhina an'amta alayhim, ghayri al-maghdubi alayhim wa al-dallin. Ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala every time, in every salah we pray. وَالنَّارُ يَصْلَاهَا الشَّقِيُّ بِحِكْمَةٍ وَكَذَا التَّقِيُّ إِلَى الْجِنَانِ سَيَدْخُلُ. Now the Shaykh is talking about الْإِيمَانُ بِالْجَنَّةِ وَالنَّارِ. Believing in the Jannah and the? These are from the what? The creations of Allah. From the creations of Allah. Al-Sunnah, what do they believe? That the Jannah and the Nar are created now. And we also believe that the Jannah and the Nar are going to forever be. Aqidat Ahli Sunnah wal Jama'ah. And we also believe that the Jannah and the Nar that Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala created, He is going to place each one to its fullest of its people. Both of them are going to be filled. Allah will fill them both up. Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. We believe that. And the people who are going to be taken to Jannah are who? The righteous people. And the people who are going to be taken to the hellfire are the wrongdoers, the criminals, the transgressors. They're going to be taken to the hellfire. And they're going to stay there. Naam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in a hadith that Abu Hurairah rahimahullah ta'ala, the hadith is narrated by Imam Muslim in his Sahih, that on the authority of Abu Hurairah, that the Prophet ﷺ, he said, "Tahajjat al-jannah wa an-nar." The Jannah and the Nar argued, debated. فقالت النار, the Nar said, "Uthirat, uthirtu bil mutakabbirin wal mutajabbirin." He said that I have been filled up with the arrogant and the tyrant rulers, the tyrant individuals who transgresses, you know, arrogant individuals. That's what I've been placed inside, who've been placed inside Jahannam. Then Jannah said, "Mali la yadkhuluni illa ad-du'afa." Why is it that the only people who enter me are the weak ones? قال تبارك وتعالى, Allah said to them, both, to the Jannah first, أنت رحمتي, you are my mercy. أرحم بك من أشاء من عبادي, I become, through you, I am mercy to whoever I want. وقال للنار, Allah said to the Nar, أنت عذابي, you are my punishment. أعذب بك من أشاء, I punish with you whoever I wish. وَلِكُلِّ وَاحِدٍ, and both of you are going to have مِلْءُهَا, it's full, it's full. You're both going to have your full, inshaAllah ta'ala. I will fool you both up. Allahumma ij'alna min al-najin. Oh Allah, make us from those who succeed to enter in Jannah. وَاكْتُبْنَا مَعَ الْفَائِزِينَ, and write us with those who are successful and prosperous. بِرَحْمَتِكَ يَا رَحْمَ الرَّحِمِينَ. Then the Shaykh rahimahullah, he said, وَالنَّارُ يَصْلَاهَا الشَّقِيُّ بِحِكْمَةٍ وَكَذَا التَّقِيُّ إِلَى الْجِنَانِ سَيَدْخُلُ وَلِكُلِّ حَيٍّ عَاقِلٍ فِي قَبْرِهِ عَمَلٌ يُقَارِنُهُ هُنَاكَ وَيُسْأَلُ. The Shaykh is now talking about the Iman, the belief of the questions of the grave, the blessings that are going to take, the bliss of the grave and the punishment of the grave. Now there's a long hadith, Hadith Al-Bara ibn Azib radiallahu ta'ala anhu, which is very long. If you go to Musnad Imam Ahmad, you'll find it there. And if you go to the ayah, يُثَبِّتُ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِالْقَوْلِ الثَّابِتِ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ وَيُضِلُّ اللَّهُ الظَّالِمِينَ وَيَفْعَلُ اللَّهُ مَا يَشَاءُ. Surah Ibrahim. If you go to that ayah, Ibn Kathir brings the hadith in its chain. The hadith, I will read some of it, inshallah ta'ala. Bara ibn Azim radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, خرجنا مع النبي, we went out with the messenger. We went out with who? The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. في جنازة رجل من الأنصار. We went out with the messenger, with a man from the people of Ansar who was being buried, who died. A man from the people of Ansar died. We were burying him. So the Prophet came out with us. فانتهينا إلى القبر, we came and we stopped at a grave. ولما يلحدوا, and the man was, lahd is when a man is placed in the grave and everything is done, he's been placed, he's been put in the grave. So now he's in the grave and this is where we're standing, where we stopped. فَجَلَسَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ, the messenger sat down. وَجَلَسْنَا حَوْلَهُ, we sat around him. Look at the students of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They all sat down around him, alayhi salatu wasalam. And when they sat with him, pay attention, they sat with him. And وَكَأَنَّ عَلَىٰ رُؤُوسِنَا الطَّيْرَ, our heads, it was like birds were on top of it. Why would they bring that parable, that example? Meaning we were so still, we didn't move. Everyone was just, no movements. The day is a very serious day. No one is moving that. We are so calm and we are so still that if a bird came, he would like stop on us, stand on us, and we wouldn't fly off because we're so still. وَكَأَنَّ عَلَىٰ رُؤُوسِنَا الطَّيْرِ وَفِي يَدِّهِ عُودٌ, the Prophet had a twig in his hand. يَنْكُتُ فِي الْأَرْضِ, he was writing it on the earth. You know when you're stressed? Yeah, the Prophet was just writing on the earth. فَرَفْعَ رَأْسَهُ, he lifted his hand up, عليه الصلاة والسلام. And then he said to the companions, إِسْتَعِيذُوا بِاللَّهِ مِنْ عَذَابِ الْقَبْرِ, seek refuge in Allah from the punishment of the grave. إِسْتَعِيذُوا بِاللَّهِ مِنْ عَذَابِ الْقَبْرِ, seek refuge in Allah from the punishment of the grave. استعيذ بالله من عذاب القبر, seek refuge in Allah from the punishment of the grave. Then the messenger said, إن العبد المؤمن, the believer. So he tells us the first type of people. So every single person is one of these two people. When he enters his grave, he's one of these two people. إن العبد المؤمن, the believer who's a mu'min, إذا كان في انقطاع من الدنيا, when he is leaving and departing this dunya, وَإِقْبَالٍ مِنَ الْآخِرَةِ, and he's facing the hereafter, and that is the stage in which he is in. He left the dunya. Turned his back towards the dunya. And now he's with what? A different creation. He's never seen them before. His eyes doesn't know who they are. All of this was before stories. Now it's a reality his eyes are looking at. وإقبالي من إذا كان في انقطاع من الدنيا وإقبالي من الآخرة نزل عليه ملائكة من السماء. This is a believer. مؤمن. What is his إيمان? It was علما وعملا واعتقادا. Belief. Knowledge. Implementation. He lived by it. He lived by لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله. His shahada, his tawheed, his following of the messenger was all intact. These angels will come down. بيض الوجوه, their faces are white. كأن وجوههم الشمس, their faces are like the sun. معهم كفن, they have a shroud with them. من أكفان الجنة, from the shrouds of Jannah. وحنوط من حنوط الجنة, and they have that حنوط from Jannah, in which when they take the soul of that person, they're going to throw their soul and everything in this beautiful prepared place to put it in it. And they will sit at a place what? مِنْهُ مَدَّ الْبَصَرُ, where his eyes can see. ثُمَّ يَجِئُ مَلَكُ الْمَوْتِ, then the angel of death will come. حَتَّى يَجْلِسَ عِنْدَ رَأْسِهِ, and he will sit next to his head. فَيَقُولُ, it will say to him, أَيَّتُهَا النَّفْسُ الطَّيِّبَةُ, oh you good soul, righteous individual, stood up for the religion of Allah. قَلْبًا وَقَالِبًا, from the heart, from outside. إِخْرُجِي, come out. To where? إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ, forgiveness, وَرِضْوَانَ, and the pleasement of Allah. فَتَخْرُجُ, it will come out. تَسِيلُ كَمَا تَسِيلُ الْقَطْرَةِ مَنْ فِي السِّقَّةِ, it will come out the way that a drop of rain comes out without any problems. It just drops smoothly, simple. The soul just comes out. فَيَأْخُذُهَا, the angel of death will take it. It won't hurt him or anything. رَاحَة. فَإِذَا أَخَذَهَا, as soon as it takes it, لَمْ يَدَعُوهَا, he doesn't let it. فِي يَدِهِ, in his hand, طَرْفَ تَعَيْنٍ, even an eye blink. No, he won't keep it that long. حَتَّى يَأْخُذُهَا, فَيَجْعَلُهَا فِي ذَلِكَ الْكَفَنِ, he places it in a shroud from Jannah. وَفِي ذَلِكَ الْحَنُوطِ, وَيَخْرُجُ مِنْهَا كَأَطْيَبِ رِيحَةِ مِسْكٍ وُجِدَتْ عَلَى وَجْهِ الْأَرْضِ, and it will leave. And the smell that comes from that soul, it smells better than the musk that you find on the earth, the best one, smell. And then he's taken up. فَيَسْعَدُونَ بِهَا فَلَا يَمُرُّونَ, they don't go by a مَلَئٍ مِنَ الْمَلَائِكَةِ, a group of angels, they don't go by them. Except these angels, they say, مَا هَذِهِ الرُّوحُ الطَّيِّبُ, what's this smell, this great soul, what is it? فَيَقُولُونَ, they say, فُلَان إِبْنُ فُلَان, this is so-and-so. And they will refer to him as what? بِأَحْسَنِ أَسْمَائِهِ, your best name. كَانُوا يُسَمُّونَهُ, in which he used to be called. فِي الدُّنْيَا, in this world. حَتَّى يَنْتَهُ بِي إِلَى السَّمَاءِ الدُّنْيَا, until they reach the سَمَاءُ الدُّنْيَا. فَيَسْتَفْتِحُونَ, they request, they finished the earth, سَمَاءُ الدُّنْيَا, and they now want to enter the place when nobody's allowed to go through, except permission has to come. So they ask for permission, and they will be given permission. فَيُفْتَحُ لَهُمْ, they will be open for them. فَيُشَيِّعُهُ السَّابِعَةِ, they take it to the seven heavens. Seven heavens. فَيَقُولُ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ, Allah says, أُكْتُبُوا, right, عَبْدِي فِي عِلِّيِّينَ, right, my servant in the عِلِّيِّينَ, the high level righteous people, right, his name there. وَأَعِيدُوهُ, and take it back إِلَى الْأَرْضِ, to the earth. Take it back to him. فَإِنِّي مِنْهَا خَلَقْتُمْ, from the earth I created him from. وَفِيهَا أُعِيدُهُمْ, and to it I will bring them back to. وَمِنْهَا أُخْرِجُهُمْ تَارَةً أُخْرَى, and from it I will bring him out once again from it, when the day of judgment comes. فَتُعَادُ رُوحُهُ, his ruh will be brought back. After that journey, it will be brought back to his body. فَيَأْتِيهِ مَلَكَانِ, two angels will then come to him. فَيُجْلِسَانِهِ, they will both sit. فَيَقُولَانِ, they will say to him, مَنْ رَبُّكَ, who's your Lord? فَيَقُولُ رَبِّيَ اللَّهِ, my Lord is Allah. فَيَقُولَانِ, they will then say to him, مَا دِينُكَ, what is your religion? فَيَقُولُ, he say, دِينِي الْإِسْلَامُ, my religion is Islam. فَيَقُولَانِ لَهُ, then they will say to him, مَا هَذَا الرَّجُلُ, who is this individual? The Prophet will be shown to them, him. And it will be said to him, مَا هَذَا الرَّجُلُ, who is this man? الَّذِي بُعِثَ فِيكُمْ, that was sent out on you. فَيَقُولُ, he will say, هُوَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ, it's the messenger of Allah. فَيَقُولَانِ لَهُ They would then say to him, وَمَا عِلْمُكَ What is your knowledge? فَيَقُولُ He says, قَرَأْتُ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ I read the book of Allah. فَآمَنْتُ بِهِ I believed in it. وَصَدَّقْتُ And I believed it. فَيُنَادِي مُنَادٍ A caller will call from the sky. And he will say, I'm صَدَقَ عَبْدِي My servant has said the truth. فَأَفْرِشُوهُ مِنَ الْجَنَّةِ Is you know when a guest is coming to you and you're preparing a plate, a bed for them and you're sorting something out, spread it out for them. Prepare farash, a place to lie down for him of Jannah. Do that for him. وَأَلْبِسُوهُ مِنَ الْجَنَّةِ And clothe him from Jannah. وَافْتَحُوا لَهُ بَابًا إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ And open a door to Jannah. فَيَأْتِيهِ مِنْ رَوْحِهَا وَطِيبِهَا And from the smell and the fragrance of Jannah comes to him. وَيُفْسَحُ لَهُ فِي قَبْرِهِ مَدَّ بَصَرِهِ The grave that he was in, that was dark, dull, it will be made wide for him until his eyes can see how far. وَيَأْتِي رَجُلٌ حَسَنُ الْوَجْهِ A man who seems beautiful will come to him. Good clothing, حَسَنُ الْثِيَابِ طِيبُ الرِّيحِ The smell is nice. فَيَقُولُ He will say to him, أَبْشِرْ Glad tidings. بِالَّذِي يَسُرُّكَ Glad tidings in that which is going to please you. In another riwayah he says, مَنْ أَنْتَ Who are you? He says to him, أنا عملك الصالح. I am your righteous actions. The good that you did, the fasting that you came with, nobody knew. The Qiyam al-Layl that you stood up, the times that you were reading and you were studying, the times that other people were doing crimes and criminal acts, you chose to remember me. Here I am. أبشر, glad tidings. بالذي يسرك, that which is going to please you. You're going to be happy, I promise you. هذا يومك الذي كنت توعد. This was the day that you were promised. And he says to him, Oh my Lord, أقم الساعة, establish the hour, حتى أرجع إلى أهلي ومالي, so I can go back to my family, my wealth, everything. I want to see Jannah, the people, my wives that are waiting for me there, my children that are waiting for me there, my life that's going to be there, my everything, يا رب, I want it to happen. Then here's the kafir, وإن العبد الكافرة, the disbeliever. إذا كان في القطاع من الدنيا, when he's leaving this dunya, وإقبالي من الآخرة, and he's turning towards the hereafter. نزل إليه من السماء comes to him from the سماء is what ملائكة سود الوجوه angels whose faces are black darkened معهم صموح فيجلسون منه مد البصر angels who have things that they want to beat him up with ثم يجيء ملك الموت the angel of death comes حتى يجلس عند رأسه he will sit next to his head فيقول أيتها النفس الخبيثة you filthy soul أخرجي كما إلى سقط the anger of من الله Allah's anger وغضب that hate that he has for you فتفرق في جسده the nafs will be leaving his body huh? فينتزعها كما ينتزع الصوف السفود من الصوف المبلول a metal rod the way it's run through a cotton which is wet how it's pulled out His nafs, his veins, his internally, he feels everything. Screaming, shouting, adab. And Allah is angry with him, what awaits him. فَيَنْتَزِعَ كَمَا يَنْتَزِعَ الصُّوفِ فَيَأْخُذُهَا فَإِذَا أَخَذَهَا لَمْ يَدَعْهَا فِي يَدْهِ He doesn't play until he places it in that sumuh that he had for him. He places it not in a shrouded from Jannah and smell. Adab is being brought from. And the smell that comes out from him, the worst smell that you can ever The smell that comes from him. And then they go by a group of angels. And when they go by the angels, they say, Who is this individual whose soul is khabith? And they say, This is Fulan ibn Fulan. They refer to him in the worst name that he ever had. And then they finish the sama'u dunya and they ask if they can be if the sama' can be open for them. Then the Prophet recited the ayah, Subhanahu wa ta'ala, where he said, La tufattahu lahum abwabu sama' wa la yadkhuluna al-jannah. حتى يلج الجمل في سم الخياط. They request for the sama to be opened for them. لا تفتح لهم. It won't be opened for them. أبواب السماء. Not at all. ولا يدخلون الجنة. And they won't enter Jannah. حتى يلج الجمل في سم الخياط. Until the camel goes through the needle. Can a camel go through a needle? The same way they won't. And then it will be written in his name in the what? أكتب في سجين. Write his name in the Sijin. Fil ardi sufla, down on the earth, right at the bottom. He's not going to go to the sama. فَتُطْرَحُ رُوحُهُ طَرْحًا His soul will be thrown into his body. Thrown into it. and it hurts him. And then the Prophet recited the ayah. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, وَمَنْ يُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ فَكَأَنَّمَا خَرَّ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ فَتَخْطَفُهُ الطَّيْرُ أَوْ تَهْوِي بِهِ فِي الرِّيحِ أَوْ تَهْوِي بِهِ الرِّيحُ فِي مَكَانِ صَحِيقٍ. When his body is taken to him, the angels will come to him, who are waiting for him, and they will say to him, مَنْ رَبُّكَ, who is your Lord? فَيَقُولُ هَا هَا. And they will say to him, مَا دِينُكَ, what's your religion? He said, هَا هَا. And they say to him, who is this man that was sent out on you? He will say, ha, ha. That's the reply he gives. A caller will call out and he will say, an kadhaba. Liar, this individual was all his life. فَفْتِشُوا لَهُ مِنَ النَّارِ, from the hellfire. وَفْتَحُوا لَهُ بَابًا إِنَ النَّارِ, open a door from the hellfire for him. And then what will happen? The heat and the smell of the hellfire will come to him. وَيُضَيِّقُ عَلَيْهِ قَبْرُهُ, his grave will be tightened on him. حَتَّى تَخْطَلِفَ فِيهِ أَضْلَاعُ, until his ribs, they pass one another. Then a person who comes to him who is ugly, whose form is extremely nasty, who's wearing the ugliest clothing, smells bad, and he'll say to him, أَبْشِرْ, glad tidings, in that which is going to harm you. And then he says to him, this is the day which you were promised. And he says, who are you? Who are you? And he says, I'm your action. I am your action. And then he said, رَبِّ لَا تَقُمِ السَّاعَةُ, Allah, don't establish the ayah. So the Shaykh rahimahullah, Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, he's using that iman, the belief of what? سُؤَالْ qabr, that the people will be asked questions in their graves. After that, the Shaykh rahimahullah, he said, هذا اعتقاد الشافعي ومالك وأبي حنيفة ثم أحمد ينقل فإن اتبعت سبيلهم فموفق وإن ابتدعت فما عليك معول. This which I mentioned in my book is the عقيدة of Imam الشافعي, محمد بن إدريس الشافعي, ومالك, مالك بن أنس, وأبي حنيفة, نعمان بن ثابت, ثم أحمد, أحمد بن حنبل, أحمد بن محمد بن حنبل. This is the aqidah they have. The four a'immatul arba'a, who the four a'immatul madhahib they follow. This is their belief. So it's not a madhab issue. Oh, my madhab don't believe this. This is the belief they have, all of them. فَإِنِ اتَّبَعْتَ, if you follow them in their path, فَمُوَفَّقْ, inshallah you're a person who receives good. وَإِنِ ابْتَدَعْتَ, if you innovate and don't follow that path, فَمَا عَلَيْكَ مُعَوَّلٌ, remember, from, there is nothing for you alternative except destruction. You're going to be destroyed in this world. So what you really need to realize is that وَاتَّبِعْ سَبِيلَ مَنْ أَنَابْ, follow the path of the righteous people in their belief, the salaf of this ummah, their pious predecessors. إِنْ لَمْ تَكُونُوا مِثْلَهُمْ فَتَشَبَّهُوا إِنَّ التَّشَبُّهُ بِالْكِرَامِ فَلَاحُ. And still remember the statement of Imam Malik, لَا يُفْلِحُ آخِرَ هَذِهِ الْأُمَّةِ لا يصلح آخر هذه الأمة إلا بما صلح بها أولها. The later generation will not find prosperity and good except in what the first generations found prosperity and good in. So the Shaykh rahimahullah ta'ala concluded there, and we will conclude there inshallah ta'ala. نسأل الله أن يهدينا إلى الحق وإصابته وبالله توفيق وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار.